Parents and families, friends and colleagues, welcome to Central Catholic's Baccalaureate Mass. My warmest congratulations to the class of 2020, whom we're gathered here to honor. These are days of well-earned celebration. Though our celebrations are not what we envision, there's still much to praise and give thanks for. This Baccalaureate Mass we celebrate today is a tradition intended to uplift the soul. It's a quieter and more intimate opportunity to reflect on all that our soon-to-be graduates have achieved and all that's ahead. Our students, this remarkable class of 2020, have learned and grown and developed in so many ways over the past 4 years. They are people of character and a potent force for good that we are about to send into the world. As parents, family, faculty, and staff, and all who gather here in support of these 248 men and women, this is our opportunity to give thoughtful attention to all they're capable of achieving and our heartfelt thanks for all that they mean to us. Members of the class of 2020, an ending is in sight, but so too is a thrilling beginning. We honor you for the good that you will do, and we give praise to God, the giver of all good things, for the gifts that manifest in you. Please join us in our opening song, City of God.
Good evening. We begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you. This evening, much as those first followers of the Lord, we enact a scene and a setting that suggests a supper. As Jesus gathered with his first followers, it was in the setting of a supper that he shared himself in a way one more time and finally with them. So we can claim the same this evening as we gather in varying settings, in varying stages, to acknowledge and to reenact that gift and disposition of the setting of the supper. The challenge for us, obviously, is how we reenact. And even at that Last Supper, this tradition identifies that as these 12 gathered with their leader, the Lord, they reclined at table. So from this setting, the visual in the back of my mind might be, how is it that we recline at the table this evening? Some might take that quite literally and say, very comfortably in the setting of our home and with family. Others might say, with a bit of a lack of familiarity. This is a first-time experience. So you two would be sharing the dispositions of these followers who, in that particular setting and on that evening, would have thought in terms of, this truly for us is a first-time experience. As the Lord, toward the end of that evening meal, the Passover, would have shared and enacted for them a first time the breaking and the sharing of the bread. So too do we in our liturgy, our ritual, reenact the same this evening. For a moment, we consider how we might be more open to our God, to one another, now particularly in the setting of our families and within our homes, how that same interaction might be continually re-enriched by the life of the Lord. Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who by the mystery of this great feast sanctify your whole church and every people and nation, pour out, we pray, the gifts of the Holy Spirit across the face of the earth. And with the divine grace that was at work when the gospel was first proclaimed, fill now once more the hearts of all believers. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. And with the spiritual calisthenics that go with our particular form of worship, at this time in our liturgy, we are asked to be seated.
A reading from the book of Sirach. When I was young and innocent, I sought wisdom. She came to me in her beauty, and until the end, I will cultivate her. As the blossoms yielded to ripening grapes, the heart's joy, my feet kept to the level path, because from the earliest youth, I was familiar with her. In the short time, I paid heed. I met with great instruction, since in this way I have profited. I will give my teacher grateful praise. I resolved to tread her paths. I have been jealous for the good, and I will not turn back. I burned with desire for her, never relenting. I became preoccupied with her, never weary of extolling her. I spread out my hands to the heavens, and I came to know her secrets. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
as the deer longs for running streams, my soul for you, the God who is my life. When shall I see, when shall I see the face of God?
As the deer longs for running streams, so
deep is calling unto deep. Over my head, all your mighty waters sweeping over me.
As the deer longs for running streams, so
a reading from the letters of St. Paul to the Philippians. I give thanks to my God at every remembrance of you, praying always with joy in my every prayer for all of you, because of your partnership for the gospel from the first day until now. I am confident of this, that the one who began a good work in you will continue to complete it until the day of Christ Jesus. It is right that I should think this way about all of you, because I hold you in my heart, you who are all partners with me in grace, both in my imprisonment and in the defense and confirmation of the gospel. For God is my witness, how I long for all of you with the affection of Christ Jesus, and this is my prayer, that your love may increase ever more and more in knowledge and every kind of perception, to discern what is of value, so that you may be pure and blameless for the day of Christ, filled with the fruit of righteousness that comes through Jesus Christ for the glory and praise of God. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Give the glory.
Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Glory to you, Lord. I am the vine, you are the branches. Whoever remains in me and I in him will bear much fruit, because without me you can do nothing. If you remain in me and my words remain in you, ask for whatever you want, and it will be done for you. By this is my Father glorified, that you bear much fruit and become my disciples. As the Father loves me, so I also love you. Remain in my love. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Who would have thought last August, as we began our school year late in the month, that things would play out as they have, as we gather this evening in our varying places of comfort, our homes, the familiarity of family, and share in this ritual that is a part of a graduation time of year for high school seniors throughout the country, throughout the world, and at all levels of education. The same distinct and unique phenomenon. And we could say, or even ask rhetorically, so how's that for a school year? In view of the times, it would be a fair question to ask. And we might consider ourselves as among the many, the millions, the billions who are asking that same question of themselves now. So here we are in a nearly empty, cavernous gymnasium in the presence of a handful, a few. We share a part of a tradition of Central Catholic High School with and for our graduating seniors. Not too many steps from this spot, maybe 100 yards away, at the front entrance of our school building, there are two visuals that represent reminders of what this school tries to represent or stand for. One partially hidden from view on the Stark Street side to the right of the steps leading up to the front entryway, obscured by a blossoming rhododendron, very much in bloom at this season, is our building's cornerstone. And on the cornerstone are the numbers 1939, the year the school opened. The reason that that number doesn't go back to an earlier date is that the world of those years was on the backside of a devastating economic depression, as well on the front side of the U.S. involvement in World War II. It would have been 75 years ago this summer that the use of a hydrogen bomb would have spelled its conclusion. And in those years, several members of those first graduating classes would have departed prematurely, not completing the exercise of graduation, owing to their commitment to serve their country. In their minds, graduation can wait. From those same entry steps going off to the left stands our flagpole, dedicated by the members of the graduating class of 2001, dedicated to those who lost their lives in the wake of 9/11. Tremors in their day, each owing to the impact on our world community. Tonight, gathering as we do in our simulated reality of a baccalaureate mass, we can think about how circumstances beyond our control continue to impact our daily lives. From this past late August, the predictable start of a school year, there's no way we might have imagined tonight's scenario. Yet in it, and caught up in it, we very much are. So we take from a tradition of our baccalaureate mass on the eve of graduation to remind ourselves that the tradition includes a spiritual dimension, thus our mass. To the mass, we add readings appropriate to the occasion, to the season. There are readings that speak of wisdom and of our wanting to borrow from its qualities, even at a very early age. They remind us to have a thankful heart for the things that the Lord has provided, with the promise that he will continue to provide. and hopefully your list grows long, considering these past 4 years. And as well, these readings remind us that we're tied together as branches to a vine, tied by a belief that in the sometimes elusive, sometimes knock me over, an awareness that catches us by surprise on occasion. And in the midst, we become that much more appreciative of that someone who has begun a good work in me, as our reading declares, and one who intends to complete in me what he has begun. In that and its promise, we take heart and hope. Our graduating class of 75 years ago would have been reminded of that message those years ago, just as our graduates of 19 years ago would have had that same thought. And so now it's to you that this same reminder is extended one more time, maybe jolted for a time, yet pliant, supple, resilient, gift of your youth that enable you to stand this test of time, just as others before you have. Jumping ahead 3 days from now, it's this coming Sunday that our church offers a timely gift as we share the Feast of Pentecost. It will be 50 days then since we've celebrated Easter, and much would have passed by us in those days as a first-time experience. The first Pentecost, those 2,000 years ago, it was a group of 12 that would have been similarly situated, astounded that their leader had risen from the dead, yet at the same time cowering at what the future might hold. So then, as well as now, this red of the vestment signs for us the significance of the season. The prayers of our Mass this evening, with its accompanying images of wind and fire of the Pentecost, are brought forward as forces beyond our nature, beyond our control, ones that continue to be at work within our lives, breathing into them the very life of our God. A God whose life breath breathes the life and provides the pulse in each one of our lives as well. May that same gift of life and its life breath continue to be at work within you this day and always. We pray that our God may bless you, you, your families, your classmates, and your future. With it, we offer our love and our prayers that they may go with you. Customarily, we would stand now as we share our profession of faith. And as much as we are able together, I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Now we share prayers of intercession. I ask that you respond to each of these individual petitions. Lord, hear our prayer. We take into account these images, these visuals to remind us of the presence of our God. Again, the fire with its great force and power, and the winds, equally forceful and yet on occasion as well very gentle. May these dispositions be reflected in these prayers that we are about to offer.
We pray for the Pope, that he continues to make sound decisions for the Church, and that the Church continues to open its doors to newcomers and those in need. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the people of the United States, that we may be united in building a society in which everyone can live with dignity and hope. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for those around the world who, in light of this pandemic, are particularly vulnerable, experience fear or anxiety, are facing difficult decisions between food on the table or public safety, or are afraid to access care due to immigration status. That we, the Church here on earth, take an active role in upholding the safety, protection, well-being, and God-given dignity of all. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for those in our community who are sick and for those who have died. May we find comfort and strength through the grace of God and the loving support of friends and family. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for our graduating seniors, that they are open to new experiences that will come through God's purpose for each of them. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for our families who are here to support us today and those who cannot be with us, in thanksgiving for their support and love that has brought our seniors to this place of accomplishment. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the faculty and staff of Central Catholic, in thanksgiving for the hours they have spent preparing our seniors with the skills and knowledge they will need for the journey forward. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the Central Catholic High School community, especially for parents, grandparents, and guardians who have loved, nurtured, and supported our seniors to bring them to this moment of success. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the prayers that we hold in the silence of our hearts, and for those prayers written in our book of prayers. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. O God, we ask that you would accept us in these our petitions and our praises, both spoken and silent. May our hearts be open always to that unconditional gift of self that you wish to share with us, both this day and always, as we offer our prayer now through Christ our Lord. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. By the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become for us our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. With humble spirit and contrite heart, may we be accepted by you, O Lord, and may our sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing to you, Lord God. Let us pray together that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept this sacrifice to the praise and glory of his name for our good and the good of all the Holy Church. Amen. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that as promised by your Son, the Holy Spirit may reveal to us more abundantly the hidden mystery of this sacrifice and graciously lead us into all truth through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. We lift them up to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and just. It is truly right and just to do
in our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, mighty and eternal God. For bringing your paschal mystery to completion, bestow the Holy Spirit on those who made your adopted children. By uniting them to your only adopted Son, the same Spirit as the Church came to earth, to all peoples the knowledge of God, and brought together the many languages of the earth and the confession of the one faith.
Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise,
and even the heavenly powers of the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glories and acclaim.
Probably best to be seated at this time through our Eucharistic prayer. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. From the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
You have said
Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May you make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints. On his constant intercession in your presence, we rely for unfailing help. In the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, Alexander and Peter, our bishops, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom we bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. This time we'd be standing as we share together in the words that Jesus has taught us. So at the Savior's command and for my divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will. Will live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Acknowledging social distancing and yet very much in the comfort and closeness of family and home, we share for the moment in this gift and disposition of Christ's peace. May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life. A prayer of reflection. Though I may not be able to receive you in Holy Communion at this point, I pray that you come and visit me by your grace, descend in a spiritual way upon my soul, and make it like yours. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who bestow heavenly gifts upon your church, safeguard, we pray, the grace you have given, that the gift of the Holy Spirit poured out upon her may retain all its force, and that this spiritual food may gain her abundance of eternal redemption through Christ our Lord. Amen. Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. May God, the Father of lights, who is pleased to enlighten the disciples' minds by the outpouring of the Spirit, the Paraclete, grant you gladness by his blessing and make you always abound with the gifts of the same Spirit. Amen. May the wondrous flame that appeared above the disciples powerfully cleanse our hearts from any harm and pervade them with its purifying light. Amen. And may God, who has been pleased to unite many tongues in the profession of one faith, give you perseverance in that same faith. And by believing, may you journey from hope to clear vision. Amen. And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you forever. Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your lives. Thanks be to God. Ordinarily, at the end of our Baccalaureate Mass, we would invite our graduates, our parents, grandparents, and families and friends to share with us a reception in our school cafeteria. Obviously, in view of the times, we're not able to provide that service. But know this evening our hearts are with you, especially for our graduating seniors and for our families and friends. And we look forward to tomorrow evening's graduation ceremony, which will bring to a conclusion your high school years. But even in our parting gesture at the Mass, we say, go, you are sent forth, which is the message of the Mass. So in a gradual sort of way, we are extending the same to you in terms of the transitioning that's now taking place within each of your lives. So with that promise and assurance, I ask God's blessings upon all of us, this evening especially, as we continue into the futures. God bless you.
It is a tradition after our baccalaureate mass that we commemorate our seniors' time at Central Catholic with a slideshow. Thank you to the members of the senior class who took on the task of not only collecting photos, but doing so at a distance. Our time together this evening is more joyous because of it. And now, the class of 2020's senior slideshow.